top rank, and he's going to share his views on the temple area. And after that, it's going to be Patrick. But now it's Kieren Bong. Please, Kieren, welcome.
Very good.
Thank you very much. I'm talking about temple today. I actually call it the forgotten temple or the denied temple. Forgotten temple because it's a part of the face that we usually forget. And it's not the part of the face that we usually immediately assess and recommend rejuvenation. Denied temple because more often than not, some of us, we don't want to do this procedure because we don't know how. Or we are a bit anxious about doing this procedure. So it's either it's a forgotten temple or it's a denied temple. Before I start with the presentation, there are three things I would just like to mention, just to set the scene. Number one, there are 300 to 400 practitioners here. It's a fine invitation event. So theoretically, all of you are experts. However, it would be fair and accurate to say that temple rejuvenation does not represent a big proportion of what we do on a day-to-day basis, isn't it? And also, it's fair and accurate to say that even the experts find it anxious and fearful when they object to the temple, and I think that's fair and accurate to say. That's not to do with the fact that the anatomy in this part of the face is very difficult to understand and very difficult to remember, and that's my personal experience over the past few years of trying to master the anatomy and the technique in this part of the face. I find it quite hard to remember and quite hard to understand, which is why it's not uncomfortable. We feel a little bit anxious about it when we are confronted with this part of the face, and which is why sometimes we deliberately forget about it or we deny our patient the opportunity to be rejuvenated in this part of the face. So that's one. Two is medicine. The practice of medicine or the learning of medicine is such that we see one, we do one, and we teach one. If you look at the techniques that's out there at the moment, one that's pioneered by Patrick, which is the gunshot technique, it's so simple. You stick a needle in all the way down to about 2 to 3 centimeters, you withdraw a little touch, and you inject bolus. Then you saw Dr. Sinho's video that he uses a multi-puncture technique, multiple boluses. That looks so simple, and we've all seen it before. But why is it that we feel anxious about it when we are approaching this part of the face? It is so straightforward. It looks easier than the lips, it looks easier than the teardrop, yet it is one that represents a very small proportion of what we do on a day-to-day basis. And also every time we perform this procedure, we hope for the best that we don't go into a vessel. Number three is we have two different instruments to use. One, hypodermic needle. Two, blunted cannula. How do you choose? A lot of it is as a result of the fact that we don't understand and have a full comprehension of anatomy to help us gain the confidence to choose the right instrument, the right technique, and to do this procedure correctly. So constructing this presentation and this technique, I have all three of that in mind. And hopefully, I will be able to fulfill that, and you will come away and you will feel that you have learned something. The temple, in summary, is a very aging part of the face. It's defined slightly differently. Usually, presentation ends with complications. I'm going to start with complications. Because one of the reasons why we are anxious about providing this procedure is to do with the fact that this is a treacherous part of the face. Complications are disastrous. And what are those complications? It can be blindness, cavernous sinus embolus, we come to the loose areola tissue. Why do we need to know about this layer? It's between the superficial and deep temporal fascia. That's to do with the fact that it's loose. It doesn't really have a lot of very important big blood vessels in there, and it's one of the safe havens where you can inject your filler. And I'll come to that a little bit more in detail. After seven structures, there are three places where you can inject your filler very safely according to the instrument you use. Remember we talked about the blood vessels are within the fascias. Hence, you can choose to inject the filler subcutaneously. There's nothing wrong with using hypodermic needle. You just need to know your anatomy extremely well, and you need to be quite brave. Now that you talked about the 7 and 3, how do we choose what to inject and what to inject with? If you need hypodermic needle, you want to go deep, very deep, just like the gunshot technique, because that is arguably, probably, the safest part you can inject. You go down to the bone, and then you inject.
This is Terry. Terry is 49 years old. About an hour ago, I was told that due to some communication breakdown, that my original model had to be withdrawn. So we managed to hijack Dr. Kesterman's patient. This is Terry, he's 49 years old, and a very healthy and good-looking 49 years old. I've checked with him whether he's allergic to anything. He's not allergic to anything. And specifically, I've checked with him whether he's allergic to lidocaine, and he's not. He has never had any dermal fillers before. Hence, I showed him the tablet. I showed him the tablet I did, and I told him that it's blunt, so there's going to be a little bit of prodding and tapping. The lateral canthus and the top part of the tragus. That, if you look at this, this is the zygomatic arch there. That's the top part of the zygomatic arch. And you have the orbital rib here. And if you were to draw a line between the lateral canthus to the top part of the tragus, or for somebody who has a low set here, you draw a line between the lateral canthus and the top of the helix, usually you're pretty spot on. So for him, I'm going to draw a line between here and the top part of the tragus. Yes, now perfect.
Okay, can you see the cannula there?
Yes, now it's
right.
Perfect.
So we want to be fairly superficial. Go up to the temporal crest, and I've got the teocell head here, at linear threading mode, and it's a blue mode, which is a medium grade, and you control the plunger very carefully with the teocell head. Okay, now to go deep, I usually pinch the skin a little bit, and Terry is going to feel a tug. Okay. Right, I've got RHA 4 this time because I'm slightly deeper, and I've got the 25 gauge 50 millimeter cannula, and the teocell pen is set at linear threading and medium mode. Control the plunger carefully. You can go a little bit slower. The reason why I use a slightly thicker product is the fact that I'm deeper.
Great. Fantastic result, Kieren. Would you sum up things and put in context? So, you will not massage.
I do massage, but be gentle. You can see the blood vessel here. Yes, but you want to be, because it's RHA, you don't need to massage it. Like,
okay.
Particularly to free check with a little bit more confidence. And with the understanding of the blood vessels, they are within the superficial temporal fascia, and also some of them are within the deep temporal fascia and within the muscle.
Okay,
great.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, Jill.
You're welcome.
Excellent presentation.